checking in here with Venroy July out here in Atlantic City, New Jersey, Resorts Casino. Venroy has quite a bit of a story behind him, but for starters, Venroy, you came out here and picked up your 16th professional victory, and you know, talk to us about the fight a little bit tonight.
It was a good fight. You know, I think for me, as you said, this is my first time kind of in this big arena in front of the lights. You know, I think nerves definitely had an impact, but it was a good step up fight. You know, it was my 16th win. Just kind of keep on winning. Every time you step in the ring, you learn something. So I'm happy about how the fight went, obviously. So,
and to give the people out there a little bit of background, you know, talking about learning and talking about a big stage, those things, for those people that do not know, Venroy actually attended Duke University and is a lawyer. So
let me correct you. I'm gonna refine.
Fix.
So I went to UNC Chapel Hill for undergrad. I got to shout out my undergrad.
Oh wow!
For undergrad, and then I went to Duke for law school.
Is that legal?
They gave me buddies.
Are you accepted when you go back to North Carolina?
I am. I'm a Carolina man. I don't have the same animosity I have for Duke as I did before, but you know, it works. As I said, I went to Carolina for undergrad, went to Duke for law school. After that, I started working at a law firm in D.C. I currently work at a law firm in Baltimore called Hogan Lovells. You know, it's one of the, I think it's like the fifth or sixth largest law firm internationally, 2,500 attorneys worldwide. I'm in the Baltimore office and kind of just trying to make these two professions work.
And now, how does an attorney, you know, become a professional fighter? Not only a professional fighter, obviously, it's not a gimmick because you're good at what you do in both formats. And, you know, your 16-1 record shows that you know what you're doing when you step in the ring as well. But what came first? Were you boxing at an earlier age or did it come later in life?
It's funny. I didn't start boxing until I was in law school. So my boxing career has been very short. I wrestled in college. I wrestled at Carolina, and then I wrestled when I went to Duke because I had a red shirt year. And when I went to the law firm that I was at in D.C., there was a partner that used to bring all the summer associates to go to have a boxing workout as a summer associate event. I went there once, kind of just fell in love with it, and I was really just doing it to kind of stay in shape. I was kind of tired of wrestling. I'd done it for like 9 years, and so I just was doing it to stay in shape. And then when I came to D.C. to start practicing full-time, I was just doing it to stay in shape, and then I started beating everybody in the gym, and so I said, I'll take some amateur fights. And then I won D.C. Golden Gloves as a novice, so I said, all right, let me try to go pro. And, you know, things have just kind of moved on from there.
And now talk about that balance. You know, obviously, both, you know, being a fighter, being an attorney are two very demanding professions. How in the world do you manage both of those things at the same time?
You know, honestly, like, it's been tough. Throughout the time that I've been trying to do both, I've had to kind of change my schedule up. So until very recently, what I was doing was I would actually wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning, and there was a gym, Champion Boxing and Fitness, that was in Rockville, which is about an hour from where I live. But they were open at 6 o'clock. So I could get up at 5, drive there, train at 6 o'clock, train until about 8 o'clock, drive back to work, be at work for 9:30, and then kind of just stay there until the deal is done. What I realized very early was, no matter how early I got to work, I could never dictate what time I was going to be able to leave. Because once you have a deal going on, you can't just like pick up and say, if the documents aren't done, you can't leave. So, you know, a lot of times I was staying there till 2-3 o'clock in the morning, and I would never get to train. And so I had to change my schedule up a little bit. And as I've gotten a little bit more senior, you know, I've been able to kind of control my schedule a little bit more, but it's still obviously very tough.
Absolutely. And, you know, what are some of the things that you hope to accomplish, you know, in boxing, obviously, you know, trying to balance the two, and, you know, what do you think we can expect from you going forward?
You know, I think, you know, as I said, I think that, you know, I started late in the game, but I'm on a accelerated pace. I'm 16-1. I absolutely intend to be the cruiserweight champion of the world. I wouldn't be doing this. The fact of the matter is that because I have the law to kind of fall back on, if I wasn't going to be serious about this, it doesn't make sense for me to do it. So I'm absolutely, you know, I take it seriously. I intend to be the cruiserweight champion of the world. And if I can do that and become a partner of my law firm, yeah, it'd be a pretty cool story.
No doubt. I guess when you step in, you know, and it, you know, somebody might have a problem with your stance on something with a court matter, you know, you can just give them a look and go ahead and probably change their mind, right?
I do corporate law, so a lot of my court group is just marking up contracts. So, but yeah, I mean, you know, it's funny because, you know, there are a lot of similarities actually between like boxing and being an attorney, but it's actually turned out to work for my benefit. Like, my law firm has been very supportive. They love it, and they tell all our clients, and so it's actually worked out pretty well for me, which is interesting because that's not what I thought was going to happen. I actually hid the fact that I boxed for the first 4 years of my career from the law firm that I was at. And then the only reason the law firm that I'm at now found out is because by the time I was interviewing, they Googled me and there were articles about me. So at that point, I couldn't lie about it anymore.
Get messed up and been too successful.
Yeah, exactly. So things have worked out well, and so we'll just kind of see how things keep going.
No doubt about it. And so I hopefully, you know, in the near future, the contract could be drawn up as one for that Cruiserweight World Championship.
That's what my plan is. I mean, slowly but surely, we're building. I mean, as I said, you know, this is our first time in a venue like this. I've been fighting on club shows, just kind of trying to beg to get on wherever I can get on. In fact, because of the fact that I couldn't get on fights, I started my own promotion company in Baltimore, in Maryland, called Hard Work Promotions. And we've actually put on 4 shows in Baltimore. I fought on 2 of them just because I couldn't get fights. And so I started my own promotion company, and we've been putting on shows in Baltimore just so I could use it as an avenue just for me to get fights.
So. Beautiful thing. I see you. I see you're able to, you know, manage on quite a few different levels, right?
You have to do what you got to do, man. Things aren't going to be as easy as you might anticipate. So you got to make your way.
Absolutely. Well, Venroy, definitely appreciate, you know, this amount of time that you, you know, shared with us today and telling a brief, you know, synopsis of your story. But I want to wish you the best of luck, both with your law profession and as a professional fighter. And no doubt about it, we'll definitely plan on seeing you in the near future.
No, I appreciate it. Thank you. All right.
Now I'm a big man with a real big mouth. And even my big mouth sometimes just can't get it done. Worldwide, international. And when I need to get my message across, I'm going to Resolution Sports. That's right, the biggest and baddest of publicity. If you got a problem, well, hey, here your resolution. Go ahead and check them out on ResSports.com. And you know, while your big deals with big matters, well, it looks like you've now got somebody on your team. You gotta do a New Year's resolution! Get that camera off.